You're giving me shivers. Running up through my spine. Giving me shivers. You're making me lose my mind. Always deliver. You know my triggers. So just do what you do. What you do. Make my body shiver.
The Morning Drive with Mike Bagley and Pete Pistone.
10 minutes before the top of the hour. Back on the Morning Drive. Jeff Gordon going to join us here in moments in studio. First, hey, Pete.
Yes.
What is today?
Today, Bagman, is Thursday, January 19th, 2023.
Today is Popcorn Day.
It's cold!
Well, as I mentioned, I did not know the whole shake the microwave popcorn bag upside down trick and let the kernels come out until I saw it a few days ago. I love popcorn. I'm a big popcorn. Shelly is the popcorn queen. Well, she's the corn queen, but she loves popcorn for sure.
What is your most favorite kind of popcorn?
I just like the good old-fashioned buttery salted popcorn. Just the old-fashioned.
Really?
Now, not that melted plastic that they sell you at the movie theaters out of that pump. You know, that's not butter. I don't know what that is. But I'm talking about the actual just butter and salt. What about you? What do you like?
Well, you do know that they put real butter in that pump. The pump is just what distributes it into the bucket or the bag.
That's not real butter. Sammy, back me up on this. You worked in a movie theater.
I'm trying to think. Yeah, we just, I mean, it was like from a tub that you just like dumped into the thing.
It's a tub.
Yeah,
thing.
But hey, I will say, if you want some good buttering and you do it yourself, put the straw in the butter. Put the, like the on top of that, and then you can like get it throughout. It's a way to layer the popcorn. People used to come in my line specifically because I was that good at layering butter in the popcorn. People would say, "I want, can I get 3 layers?" And I'd say, "I can do that for you."
Wow.
There's like a viral video of a guy working at on TikTok.
That guy shaking the big bag.
That's
unbelievable.
Petey,
I've seen that.
Petey, that was me as a 16-year-old working at the Regal Cinemas Village Park 17. That's
that
what
guy
I was doing.
Really? I would get in your line totally if I saw that happening.
Well, hang on a second. Now that we're into the movie part,
yeah,
the movie theaters, whether it be AMC, Regal, Cinemark, whoever you are, there needs to be a better creation of the container for the popcorn because, as you know, when the movie starts and people are going wrist and elbow deep into those containers, it's very noisy, whether it's the bag or some people go in there a little too hard and now you got, you know, wrists and fingers banging off the sides of the bucket, and it gets very distracting when you're trying to watch the movie. The bag more than the bucket.
The Alamo Draft House by us gives us very nice metal bowls, which are great, until you're sitting next to someone with a bunch of jewelry on, and they're they're click-clacking. They're trying to, you know, grab the popcorn, clink, 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 and you're like, I can't escape it.
Well, now you got people coming in at Synergy. Who had the medium rare steak? You know, take it easy. It's like they're serving you meals, for crying out loud.
Actually, this is more like medium.
Yeah, take it back, please. I'm trying to watch the movie. The guy's got his flashlight app on his phone. This looks rare to me. Bring this back. Come on.
My favorite popcorn is kettle corn. And some of the best kettle. Okay, thank you, Davey. The best kettle corn I've had was the Phoenix Raceway. The old Copper World Classic, as it were. I remember going and getting it. They had the big old vat, man. They're making it. You can smell it.
Oh, yeah.
Matter of fact, that scent drew me. Matter of fact, Dad, when he owned his ice cream store in the mall, he would strategically pop popcorn at certain times of day to create the scent throughout the mall to bring people to the store.
What a guy. What a businessman. What a businessman. What a salesman.
He'd look at me, be about, you know, 10:45 in the sun, get over there and get us some popcorn going. You get some people in here. You do exactly that.
It's corn.
And it worked.
Did it have the juice?
Today is Get to Know Your Customers Day.
Well, hello, everybody. Thanks for tuning in here.
And he got to know his customers when he popped that popcorn to get him in there.
They're like, must have popcorn.
Is that from a fungal infection, or is that just from...
Ew.
The Last of Us.
On this day, in 1764, John Wilkes was expelled from the British House of Commons for seditious libel.
Now, is that the same guy that took down Lincoln?
Pete, that's like 100 years in...
So not the same guy.
No, okay. I think he was.
No Booth was stacked onto the end of that Wilkes.
I had the same thought.
How could you have the same thought?
I'm not a history buff. I hear John Wilkes. I'm like, oh, it's the guy.
Plus, I was thinking theater because we're talking popcorn.
But you're not
Booth. It's just the chair, not the booth.
The barstool.
Good morning to Shirley Booth. She played Hazel. Mr. B.
Okay. All right. Hello. Check, check. On this day in 1793, King Louis the 16th was tried by the French Convention, found guilty of treason, and sentenced to the guillotine. What the hell's going on with all these people? All the seditious libel and guillotines and all this stuff.
Wait a minute. I want to see. I want to see the Roman numeral behind that name. Are you sure it's 16th?
Yeah, XV1.
Okay, that's good. It's good for you. You did that on the fly. I'm not good at my Roman numerals.
On this day in 1825, Ezra Daggett and Thomas Kensett of New York City patented a canning process to preserve salmon, oysters, and lobsters.
Yes. Good morning, Joe Madison.
Good morning.
First of all, I just want to say we tried the wild caught salmon. Me and my wife, we love it.
Oh, great! Okay. You from the wild Alaska.
Right. Exactly.
Oh, great, man! It's and you like the proportions. I assume there was no waste. Yeah. Okay, good. I'm glad. You know, I'll let them know.
When did Joe do a thing on salmon?
Was he got a side hustle? He's a fishmonger?
What's going on?
Times are tough at SiriusXM, guys. You got to celebrate.
Hey, you know what? Man's got to eat.
I don't know. Something's fishy.
on this day in 1937, Howard Hughes set a transcontinental air record. He flew from Los Angeles to New York City in 7 hours, 28 minutes, and 25 seconds.
I'm on the phone. I'm on the plane. I'm calling you from the plane.
Guess where I'm calling you from?
Sure, that wasn't a Southwest flight?
I was going to say 728-25. That puts him in American Airlines territory right there. On this day in 1944, the U.S. federal government relinquished control of the nation's railroads after a settlement of a wage dispute.
I'm going off the rails on a crazy train.
Crazy train, Peggy.
On this day in 1949, the salary of the President of the United States was increased from $75,000 to $100,000 with an additional $50,000 in expense allowance for each year in office.
Oh, you're a rich girl, and you're going too far, 'cause you know it don't matter anyway.
Does the president have to turn in the receipt when he puts that expense report in? I would think.
I don't know how that works. Is that a per diem? I mean, did they just take his word for it? Did they just give it to him up front and he spends it on his own?
Mr. President, did you put that in concur? Because we're going to need you to actually do that and provide that for we can actually let this go through.
What's with the large frosty? Come on.
So listen, I found this out in one of the documentaries I watched. So the president and the first lady and the first family, they actually have to pay for the food that is cooked for them by the executive chefs.
Really?
It's not given to them. They have to buy it.
Well, I should call Joe Madison. They get a deal on salmon anyway.
And on this day in 1953.
I love Lucy and
68% of all TV sets in the U.S. were tuned to CBS as Lucy Ricardo of I Love Lucy gave birth to a baby boy.
Did you know there were words to that theme song? I didn't think I knew
did not
that
know. I've never heard that before. Wow. We advanced to birthdays. Lots of them. Celebrating a birthday today. Dolly Parton is 77. Mac Miller would have been 31. Edgar Allan Poe would have been 214. Janis Joplin would have been 80. Sean Wayans, 52. Paula Deen, 76. Robert E. Lee would have been 216. Jensen Button is 43. Katie Seagal, 69. Pete Buttigieg, 41. And Lil Scrappy is 39.
Okay, Lil Scrappy, Big Scrappy, happy birthday to everybody on this Thursday, January 19th, 2023.